Warning: recreation of this recipe is at own risk. The maker of this video and or anyone involved are not responsible for any allergic reactions and or any physical or mental injury of any kind. If you have any doubts about any unwanted reaction to any of the ingredients, then do not try to recreate this recipe and or consume it in any way. Hi guys, and welcome to an all new first episode, pilot-ish, tryout-ish thing called Dinner with Ardawen. Today, we're going to make something that I like to call Chicken Pineapple Surprise a la Ardawen. You notice that I'm not really going into how many to use from what. That's mainly because I normally cook like this. I will say something and give a little bit of explanation with it, but a lot of this dish is mainly to taste. In this case, I'm making dinner for two persons. Because we're having a guest today, and I picked chicken meat of about 400 grams, 500 grams, that should be enough. And that is going to be cut into pieces, little chunks. I will show you what kind of chunks after I cut them. And there we are. Well, I cut the chicken into little chunks. As you might see, they're not the same size, and that doesn't really matter in this case. You will see why. What we're going to do now is spice them a little bit with salt and pepper. Not too much though, because you don't want the chicken to be tasteless. However, it's going to be inside a sauce, so it's not the most important part of the dish. So we're going to add some salt. And some pepper. And I still have some. Well, you know, it doesn't matter. You see, this is how it goes. It doesn't even really matter that I don't have pepper, because again, it's the least important part of the dish. So instead, I just added a little bit of onion powder, not too much, just to again to make sure that the chicken isn't completely tasteless. And a little bit of garlic powder, not too much, because there is already going to be a lot of garlic into the dish itself. And then I'm going to mix that with the chicken. Now, talking about the chicken, I actually bought biological meat, and if you have the chance and the money for it, by all means do so, because it's the kind of meat, at least here, that is a little bit more animal friendly, as far as meat can be animal friendly, than normal meat. And therefore, I prefer it because I like animals, but I do like my meat. You don't know what I'm saying. So, washing up here. Next, we're going to make sure that your chicken is done. between. In this pan, we're going to prepare the entire dish except for the rice. But I'm not going to explain how to make the rice for you because, come on, it's rice. You know how to do that, right? So, just a little bit of butter. I used liquid olive oil butter. Simply because it's still butter, but it's a little bit healthier than most other butters. Let me just wipe the gas here. And maybe stir the pan will be nice and hot. So, I will be coming. No. While the butter is getting hot, we can focus on the pineapple. So I already bought pre-cut pineapple in a can with the juice, because we also need the juice.
So while our butter is getting nice and hot here,
I'm going to take out some pineapple because we don't need all. And you know, some pineapple is not so nice to go with your dessert. But I only take out the little pineapple things and not the juice because, again, we're going to need the juice. Now I see that the butter is hot. Let's just get me something to hold the pan here. We're going to put in the chicken. I could have known, but I did a little bit too little butter. But you know, I prefer to do too little than too much because I can always add some. There we go. Do know that if you just want to have enough butter for the chicken not to burn until the sauce, until you're preparing the sauce, and that's all you need, just a little bit. You just don't want it to burn. And you know, one of the reasons I use a pan like this is I can just put on the lid. And I know the chicken will be okay for now. When I put the gas a little bit lower, and I can focus. Okay, now focus on the pineapple. So we're going to take out the rest of the pineapple that we are going to use, but leave the juice inside the can because the can is a handy free working tool for later. And we're just going to cut pineapple quickly into small parts. Not too small, or as you want it to be small. Just as big as you want. But remember,
you want to eat it from a spoon or a fork. So you don't want them to be too small, but not too big. But you can go as big as you want, or as small as you want. It's up to you. It doesn't affect your taste. But I like to cut them nice and small. So we already prepared this, and now let's check on the chicken. A little bit more. So in the meantime, we can focus on the juice. You're not going to just keep it like that. We're going to add just a little bit of sugar because I like it sweet. Oh, still close. There we go. But just a little bit. And we're going to add some garlic. Already ready to here, so we can already mix. We can mix it in a sauce later on, if we want to. But we don't really need it. And a thing where the chicken was in later, we can now use like a nice, as a nice garnish. So I'm just going to use, I'm going to show you how much garlic I'm going to use for two persons. And for now, because I'm going to taste it if I think it's enough or not. But again, like most things in this dish, it's mainly up to your own taste. Don't listen to me too much when it goes to these, goes to how many I put into it. But I'm going to use this many garlic for two persons until now. I'm a garlic eater, and I happen to know that my guest does not dislike garlic as well. But do know, not everyone might like garlic as much as you do. So the rest goes into the garbage bin, and then I take a spoon again, just for the taste, just a teeny little bit of sambal. Look, I have no idea how this is named in the United States, but here it's called sambal. Ball. And we're going to mix it. There. In the meantime, it needs a little bit more mixing. We're going to check out the chicken again. That looks good. a little bit too much fat though. But that's what you get, I guess. It doesn't really matter. You can pour it off, I guess, but we're not going to do that. It doesn't really matter. So a little bit mixing up. Now we're going to put this higher again because we can now pay a little bit more attention to the chicken. And we just want to be sure that it's at least almost completely done. And that there are some brown spots on the chicken here and there. You know, we're not going to check it because the boiling of the sauce and the amount of time the rest of the dish would take, we'll take care of making the chicken completely done. You know, we just want to be sure that it's completely okay. I think the chicken is alright for now. So now we're going to add our prepared sauce thing. Add it to the chicken. Of course, we're going to stir that around a little bit. And then we're going to wait until it boils. That doesn't take too long. It already begins to boil. So now we're going to add the pineapple. And make sure it's mixed around nice. There. Now we're going to add soy sauce, or like it's called here, ketchup mayonnaise. If soy sauce is the right translation, well, excuse me. Well, that's good. What Google Translator said. And we're going to add some soy sauce to it. Yes. Quite some. Don't be afraid to use too much or too little. Again, it's our tastes. I see that I use a little bit more than I would use normally. That's okay. You have to be careful. You have to be a little bit careful with how much you use, but it's more or less after taste. And we can make, still make this broth. Let's just... take a little sip. What I'm going to add now is some djahé and some jintan. Just to give it an extra taste, when you say, hey! That spice box isn't really working, this one is. There we go. Just to give it a taste that may that makes you think of the Asian lands. At least that's what kind of what Asian foods taste like here sometimes. So now let's see how it tastes. Well, that's a lot better. So, I know I said be careful with garlic, but for my personal taste, I use a little bit too less. So we're going to add a little bit more. While it's boiling, if you wanted to. Boil extra good. Put on the lid. But be careful not to boil over. Now you can lower the gas a little bit. This way the pan will still stay hot and you won't use as much gas. That is why I like pans like these. They really close up when you put on a lid. Now, let me see where my other, there it is, the other end of my garlic squisher. Of course you can use powdered garlic. If you like, I use some to spice up the chicken. But personally, I like fresh garlic a little bit more. It just has a little bit more taste than powdered garlic. But then again, garlic is pretty easy to come by here. And I'm not sure how that is where you are. In other words, I'm not sure how it is in other countries. But if you have it available for a good price, use fresh garlic. It tastes so much better. So again, I'm going to mix it up so that the garlic gets spread nicely. And basically, this is the dish. That's all there is to it. If the taste is right. So again, let me first do it like this. Terrific. Now what you will notice is that your sauce is a bit watery. But of course, when almost every kitchen prince or princess knows is that there is a solution for everything. What have I forgot to find the translation, but here it is called maizena. Don't use too much of it. Just a little tiny bit, but it could make your sauce a little bit stiffer, which is doesn't help with the taste, but it makes eating it a lot easier. So I don't got it's a bit awkward in fact because someone gave this to me. Because I was all out. So I just do a little bit in the cup. We can use a little bit more. Wash my hands. Then we add a little bit more to it. This must be enough. I usually don't do this, but because I'm not sure if I'm doing this right. Usually I just take the watery sauce and go with it. So this must make the sauce. No, I think I will use too little. Use a little bit too little. Mix it up with a little bit of water first. There we go. This looks more like when it was shown to me. There we go. More like it. Now, of course, we have to wait again until it boils. We turn up the gas a little bit. And then, when you're done, there it goes again. Your kitchen will probably look like a mess if you work like me. Got your dish. Your dish will look like just about like this. Chicken pineapple surprise a la Ardawen. Bon appetit. So, if you try this out in your own kitchen, please do tell me how you liked what you liked of it, and maybe you did some variations with it or something else. I really would like to know what you did it with and how you liked it, etc. Just post it below. There we go. Just post it below in the comment section. Also tell me what you thought of the series, because this is just a tryout. I'm not sure if I'm going to do this again or whatever. So yeah, this is just a little tryout on how to make an easy dish. It just took about 30 minutes. And yeah, I have nothing to say anymore, so I'm going to sign off here. I'm going to have a wonderful dinner with my guest. I will tell you how my guest liked it, because this guest never had this dish before. Then we'll talk to each other again. Bye guys!